Very good morning, students. Today we will going to focus our next chapter, that is chapter number 6, distillation. Basically, this distillation is an unit operation which involves the separation of a vaporizable component from a multi-component system and subsequent condensation of vapors. It has been practiced early as 3500 BC for isolation of odoriferous principles from flower petals, leaves, etc. So, in the field of pharmaceutical engineering, distillation plays a very crucial role and is considered as one of the essential mass transfer process. So, we will going to focus a very simple definition of distillation. So, distillation is an unit operation which involves the separation of a vaporizable component from a multi-component system and subsequent condensation of vapors. In another sense of term, the distillation is also defined as a process of separating the component substances from a liquid mixture by selective evaporation and condensation. Distillation is also defined as the separation of components of a liquid mixture by a process involving vaporization and subsequent condensation at another place. So, when we go with the historical events of distillation process, so it was practiced as early as I have already told you in 3500 BC for the isolation of odoriferous principles from the flowers, leaves, etc. In 11th and 12th century, it was used for the isolation of alcohol from wines, and in Ayurveda, the process of separation of active constituents of crude drugs also mentioned. Basically, when we talk on this distillation process, so the two major phases involve the mass transfer from both the phases to one another. Are a liquid phase and another is vapor phase, that is your gas phase. So liquid phase, in this phase the mass is transferred by means of vaporization, whereas in case of vapor phase or the gas phase, which is achieved by supplying heat to the liquid, mass is transferred through the condensation, and this phase consists of higher percentage of volatile components than the liquid phase. So distillation is normally achieved when the concentration of vapor and liquid phases in equilibrium are different from each other, else the separation of components still not takes place. So generally this process is used in the chemical and petroleum industries for the separation of components of the liquid mixture. Some of the typical examples of the distillations are separation of ethanol and water mixture. Second would be production of your absolute alcohol from 95% ethanol using benzene, and third would be separation of crude petroleum into gasoline, kerosene, fuel oil, etc. Next, this is the distinguishing characteristics of distillation with respect to evaporation and the dry. When we are going with the differentiation point of distillation, evaporation, or even distillation drying, then we'll come to know that at initial phase, the first point would be the vaporization of bulk liquid above boiling point. Then in case of distillation, that point it is there. In case of evaporation is vaporization of bulk liquid below the boiling point. So it is exactly opposite of the distillation process, whereas in case of drying, the slow evaporation of the wet solid bulk, that is small amount of liquids, gonna take place. Second differentiating point for the distillation is product desired is distillate, that is your solvent used. In case of evaporation, the product desires is concentrated liquid, that is concentrated solute. And in case of drying, the product desires is solid residue, that is your dried solute. And third point would be, in case of distillation, would be process of separation of the components of liquid mixture. In case of evaporation, the process of removal of the liquid solvent. And in case of drying, the process of complete removal of the liquid solvent. Okay, So with this passion, we can summarize, we can even elaborate much more about the distillation, evaporation and drying so far. This is your applications of distillation, where it is useful for the separation of volatile oils. Examples I have cited here, that is GLOW, which consists of eugenol. We all known about that pharmacognosy part, which comprises 72 to 90% of vanillin, percent of eugenol there in case of GLOW, vanillin and acetyl eugenol. Second applications is separation of drugs obtained from the plant and animal sources. Vitamin A from the fish liver oil is the example here. Purification of organic solvent, that is absolute alcohol, which is obtained, that is 100%. Purification of drugs obtained from the chemical process here. The fourth applications would be manufacture of official preparation. Examples are spirit of nitrous ether, spirit of ammonia, distilled water and water for the injections. Then next applications is quality control method, wherein alcohol contained in elixirs has been measured by means of this method and distillation method rather. So obtained of alcohol content there in case of elixir is 4 to 40%. Then second last application would be refining of petroleum products. The example is petroleum ether 60 and 80. And last application would be recovery of the solvent synthesis. There are the various type of the terminology has been used while learning much more about the distillation. So very first terminology is binary mixture. So what exactly the binary mixture is? When two liquids mix together, they may be miscible with each other in all proportion. Such miscible liquids are known as binary mixture of the liquids. Example, ethanol plus water, or acetone or water, or benzene and carbon tetrachloride. So these are the examples of binary mixture. Next is a perfect solution, that is ideal solution. Ideal solution is defined as the one in which there is no change in the properties of the components other than the dilution when they mix to form a solution. That solution is called as ideal solution. So the property of ideal solution is the total volume of solution is equal to sum of volume of each component. Second property, no heat absorbed and no heat evolved. Third property would be no chemical reactions in between. Fourth property would be final volume of solution represents additive property of individual components. And the fifth property would be it follows the Raoult's law. Next is real solution. Most of the system shows the varying degree of deviation from Raoult's law depending on the nature of liquids and temperature. So these solutions are known as real solution. Property for the real solution is heat may absorb or evolve here. Second property would be chemical reaction occurs in between. Third property would be final volume of solution represents additive property of individual components. And fourth property would be it doesn't follow the Raoult's law. So the example of the real solution is carbon tetrachloride plus cyclohexane or chloroform plus your acetone. So these are the examples I have cited here for the real solution. Next is volatility. Volatility of any substances in solution may be defined as the equilibrium partial pressure of substance in vapor phase divided by the mole fraction of substance in the solution. Example is a substance A in a liquid mixture has partial pressure PA and its concentration in the mixture is XA on mole fraction scale. So volatility of component A is equal to partial vapor pressure of A divided by mole fraction XA of A in solution. So your final solution, so for the final equation for the volatility is VA is equal to P Pa upon Xa. So wherein the volatility of a material in the pure state is equal to the vapor pressure of the material. Next is relative volatility. Consider a liquid mixture containing two components A and B. In such a case, the volatility of one component is expressed in terms of second as below. So relative volatility is equal to volatility of component A, that is VA, divided by volatility of component B, that is VB, where your final equations would be RV is equal to VA upon VB. When we talk on the conversion of gram to mole, so I have cited here the example, that is convert 25 grams of KMnO4, that is potassium permanganate, to moles. So wherein we'll have to consider here the molecular weight of KMnO4. So the atomic number we'll have to consider here, that is for the K, manganese, oxygen. Okay, so here the calculation takes part the total molecular weight for the KMnO4 at initial level when we talk about the atomic number, that is 158.034 gram per mole. So 25 grams when we consider that KMnO4, so what actually the mole for the 25 grams? Then that 25 gram which will have to divide it by means of the 158.034 gram per mole. So your answers would be 0.158 mole. So your answers would be 25 gram of KMnO4 when we convert into the moles, then your answers would be 0.158 mole of your KMnO4 for the 25 gram of the quantity. Next terminology is your vapor pressure. Vapor pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by a vapor in thermodynamic equilibrium with its condensed phase, that is solid or liquid, at a given temperature in a closed system. So the equilibrium vapor pressure is an indication of a liquid vapor evaporation rate. Thermodynamic equilibrium is the systematic study of transformation of matter and energy in system as they approach equilibrium, and the word equilibrium implies a state of balance. Next terminology is azeotropic mixture, that is constant boiling mixture. Mixture of a special composition giving minimum or maximum boiling point than individual component with minimum or maximum boiling point respectively. So the examples are mixtures with maximum boiling point which contain 20.2 ml of HCl plus 79.8 ml of water. So it is the mixtures with the maximum boiling point. And second example is mixtures with the minimum boiling point, wherein the mixtures contain 95.5 ml of alcohol, wherein 4.5 ml of water we have to add. So this is a perfect example of mixtures with the minimum boiling point. This is a simple distillation assembly where if you could able to see this diagram, then the construction and working are easily known to us. So we'll see the general requirement or the equipment which is required for the simple distillation. The very first general equipment for the distillation is your steel. Steel, it is a vaporizing chamber and used to place the material to be distilled. The steel is heated by a suitable means for the vaporization of the volatile constituents. On the laboratory scale, round bottom flask made of glass are used so that the progress of the distillations can be noticed. A condenser is attached to the steel using appropriate joints. A trap is inserted between the distillation flask and the condenser. The next general equipment for the distillation is your condenser. It is used to condense the vapor and it is kept cold by circulating the water or air through the jacket. So the types of the condensers are of three types: single surface condenser, double surface condenser, and multi-tubular condensers. Single surface condenser, which having the different subtypes: straight tube, bulb type, spiral, and coil type single surface condenser. Whereas the condenser is connected to a receiver through a suitable adapter. So these are the few condensers I have cited here, which is as straight tube type, bulb type, spiral type, coil type, cold finger or the spiral tube, and Lucas, that is your double surfaces. Okay, so these are the appropriate condensers you can use, whatever the materials you wanted to make it distilled. It is totally depend upon our objective or the expectations toward the distillation assembly. Next equipment is your receiver. So it is used to collect the distillate. It may be a simple flask. It immerses in ice bath to minimize the loss of volatile matter. Florentine receivers are used for the separation of oil and water. So you have been always asked in the examination what type of the receivers are going to be used for the separation of oil and the water. So your answers would be Florentine. So the types of the Florentine receivers are of two type. Type 1, which is useful for the separation of oil heavier than the water, and type 2, it is used for the separation of oil lighter than the water. So these are the diagram. If you could able to understand to see this image, so water outlet is there at the bottom for oils lighter than the water, so that is obviously your type 2 one. And on exactly of your right hand side, the receivers you could able to see, so it is example of your type 1, wherein it is useful for the separation of oil heavier than the water. So if you could understand, if your oil is get lighter than the water, then obviously it is going to float over the surface of your water. That means the density of water is quite of high as compared to your oil. So that's why the oil outlet, it is attached at the upper side of the receiver, where in case of your type 1, that is, it is useful for the separation of oil heavier than the water, then obviously here in case the oil which having the density which is quite more as compared to the water, so that's why it residues or sediment at the bottom of your receiver. So obviously the outlet is at the bottom. This is the classification of distillation methods, where and if you could able to see this classification. So simple distillation, that is differential distillation you can say in another word, flash distillation, that is equilibrium distillation. Third is vacuum distillation, wherein distillations can be done under the reduced pressure. Fourth method is your molecular distillation, that is evaporation distillations or the short path distillation. Fifth one would be fractional distillation, that is rectification. Sixth class is your azeotropic and extractive distillation. Seventh would be steam distillation. Eighth would be destructive distillation, and ninth would be compression distillation. So we'll going to discuss it one by one. First is your simple distillation. Simple distillation is a process of converting a single constituent from a liquid or the mixtures into its vapor. So transferring the vapor to another place and recovering the liquid by condensing the vapor, usually by allowing it to come in contact with a cold surface. So this process is known as differential distillation, as distillation is based on the differences in volatilities and vapor pressure of the components in the mixture. As far as the principle of this simple distillation is concerned, so the principle of this simple distillation is liquid boils when its vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. The simple distillation is conducted at its boiling point. The higher the relative volatility of liquid, the better is the separation by simple distillation. And heat is supplied to the liquid so that it boils. The resulting vapor is transferred to a different place and condense. As far as the application of the simple distillation is concerned, for the preparation of this distilled water and water for the injection, volatile and aromatic waters are prepared, organic solvents are gonna purified, a few official compounds are prepared by means of distillation. Examples are spirit of nitrous ether and aromatic spirit of ammonia. And last applications would be non-volatile solids are separated from the volatile liquids. So this is your simple distillation assembly, wherein you can say that laboratory scale apparatus for the simple distillation. So we'll see the construction for this simple distillation. Basically, it consists of your distillation flask with a side arm sloping downwards. Condenser is fitted into the side arm by means of a cork. The condenser is usually water condenser that is jacketed for the circulation of water. The condenser is connected to a receiver flask using an adapter with ground glass joints. On a laboratory scale, the whole apparatus is made up of glass, and it consists of a distillation flask with a side arm sloping downward. Condenser is fitted into the side arm by means of a cork. So the procedure for this, the liquid to be distilled is filled into the flask to 1/2 to 2/3 of its volume. Bumping is avoided by adding small pieces of porcelain before distillation. A thermometer is inserted into the cork and fixed to the flask. The thermometer bulb must be just below the level of the side arm. Water is circulated through the jacket of the condenser and the contents are heated gradually. The liquid begins to boil after some time and the vapor begins to rise up and passes down the side arm into the condenser. And then the temperature rises rapidly and reaches a constant value. The temperature of the distillate is noted down, which is equal to the boiling point of the liquid, and the vapor is condensed and collected into the receiver, and the flame is adjusted so that the distillate is collected at the rate of 1 to 2 drops per second. So distillation should be continued until a small volume of liquid remains in the flask. So this is all about the construction and working of your simple distillation assembly. Okay, so but when we talk on the uses of it, it is used for the producing the distilled water and the water for injection. It is used in the preparation of volatile and aromatic solvents. It is used in the purification of organic solvents. It is also used in the preparation of spirit of nitrous ether and aromatic spirit of ammonia, and it is used for the separating non-volatile solids from the volatile liquids. As far as the merits of these simple distillation assembly is concerned, so the advantage of this assembly is a very simple than used for the fractional distillation. The liquid mixtures are distilled rapidly. It utilizes the minimum energy as compared to the fractional distillation, and the solvents are collected and recycled without releasing vapors into the atmosphere. As far as the demerits is concerned, so the liquids with higher boiling point differences can only be distilled. Second demerit is degree of separation achieved is lesser than that achieved by the fractional distillation. And fourth one is it works well with relatively pure liquids. So next one, we do have the flask distillation. If you could able to see this diagram and understand the different types of labeling conditions are there, that is feed, pump, heater, pressure reducing valve, vapor to condensate, then vapor separators and the liquid. So it is basically a continuous process in which the liquid mixture is allowed to pass from a higher pressure zone to a lower pressure zone, results in sudden vaporization of the liquid. It is simply referred to as an flash distillation. So as far as definition of this flash distillation is concerned, it is a process in which the entire liquid mixture is suddenly vaporized, that is flash, by passing the feed from a higher pressure zone to a lower pressure zone. So flash distillation is also known as equilibrium distillation, that is separation is attempted when the liquid and the vapor phases are in equilibrium. This method is frequently carried out as a continuous process and does not involve the rectification. The principle for the flash distillation is when a hot liquid mixture is allowed to enter from a high pressure zone into low pressure zone, the entire liquid mixture is suddenly vaporized. So this process is known as flash vaporization. During this process, the chamber gets cooled. The individual vapor phase molecules of high boiling fraction get condensate, while low boiling fraction remains as vapor. As far as the working of these flash distillation is concerned, so the feed is pumped through a heater at a certain pressure. The liquid gets heated, which enters the vapor liquid separator through a pressure reducing valve. Due to the drop in pressure, the hot liquid flashes, which further enhances the vaporization process. This sudden vaporization induces the cooling, and the individual vapor phase molecules of high boiling fraction get condensate, while low boiling fraction remains as vapor. So the mixture is allowed for a sufficient time so that the vapor and the liquid portion separate and achieve the equilibrium. Okay, and wherein the vapor is separated through a pipe from above and liquid is collected from the bottom of the separator by continuously feeding into the steel, it is possible to obtain continuous flash distillation. The operating conditions can be adjusted in such a way that the amount of feed exactly equals the amount of material removed. Therefore, the vapor and the liquid concentrations at any point remains constant in the unit. Okay, as far as the uses of this flash distillation assembly is concerned, so flash distillation is used for the separating components, which boils at widely different temperatures. It is widely used in the petroleum industries for the refining crude oil. Advantage of this flash distillation is a continuous process. Simply, disadvantages of this flash distillation is it is not effective in separating the components of the comparable volatility, and it is not an efficient distillation when nearly pure components are required, because the condensed vapor and the residual liquids are far from pure. Okay, next one we do have the vacuum distillation, that is steam under the reduced pressure. So if you could able to understand these diagram, that is steam under reduced pressure, you could able to understand the different labeling condition and its significance. Okay, so pinch cork is there to hold the tube, then thermometer is there, which is exactly shows your the U-tube type of the tube, then capillary tube, Claisen flask, water bath is there at the bottom. Then at the slantic one, we do have the condenser for the condensation mechanism. To vacuum pump is there, and there is a receiver to collect your feed. Okay, so we'll see one by one. So the distillation process in which the liquid is distilled at a temperature lower than its boiling point by the application of vacuum. So the vacuum pumps, suction pumps, etc. are used to reduce the pressure on the liquid surface. Distillation under the reduced pressure is based on the principle of simple distillation with some modification. As far as the principle is concerned, wherein the liquid boils when vapor pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure, that is pressure on its surface. If the external pressure is reduced by the applying vacuum, the boiling point of the liquid is lowered. Therefore, the liquid boils at a lower temperature. This principle is illustrated using an example of water. Water boils at an 100 degrees Celsius, we all of us know not of about it, at an atmospheric pressure is 101.31 kilopascal, that is 760 mm of Hg pressure is required for that. At 40 degrees Celsius, the vapor pressure of water is approximately 9.33 kilopascal, that is your 70 mm of Hg. Hence, the external pressure is reduced to 9.33 kilopascal, that is 770 mmHg, whereas where water boils at 40 degrees Celsius. So the net results in the is the increase in rate of mass transfers into the vapor. So the important factor in evaporation is mass of vapor form, which is directly proportional to the vapor pressure of evaporating liquid, but inversely proportional to the external pressure. So according to this formula, water is allowed to evaporate at 40 degrees Celsius and 9.33 kilopascal, that is 7 mmHg pressure is required. So the mass of vapor form in unit time is approximately 11 times, that is 760 upon 70 for the water. So as far as the construction is concerned, basically it consists of double neck distillation flask, which known as normally the Claisen flask. Thick walled glass apparatus with interchangeable standard glass joints are used for the vacuum distillation. In one of the neck of the Claisen flask, a thermometer is fitted. So the second neck prevents the splashing of the volatility agitated liquid. Bumping occurs radially during the vacuum distillation. Placing a fine capillary tube in the second neck of the flask can prevent the bumping. And the capillary tube is dipped in the boiling liquid so that a stream of air bubbles is drawn out. Water bath or oil bath is used for the heating. The Claisen flask is connected to a receiver through a condenser, and the vacuum pump is attached through an adapter to the receiver. A small pressure gauge, that is manometer, should be inserted between the pump and the receiver. As far as the application of this vacuum distillation assembly is concerned, it prevents the degradation of active constituents at 55 degrees Celsius. Enzymes, that is malt extract, pancreatin, vitamins, that is thiamine and ascorbic acid, glycoside, that is anthraquinone, and alkaloids like hyoscyamine to atropine. As far as the disadvantages of this vacuum distillation assembly is concerned, and the reduced pressure, so it persistently foaming occurs there. This may be overcome by adding the capril alcohol to the liquid or by inserting a fine air capillary tube in the second neck of the Claisen flask. The stream of air is drawn in and breaks the rising foam. The above method is not actually suitable for the preparation of semi-solid or solid extract by the distillation under the vacuum. Okay, so when we talk on these demerits, it is basically cannot be used for the preparing the semi-solid or the solid extract. Next friends, we do have the molecular distillation. Molecular distillation is also known as evaporative or short path distillation. Basically depends on the principle of simple distillation with some modification. Basically it is defined as the distillation process in which each molecule in the vapor pressure travels mean free path and gets condensed individually without intermolecular collisions on application of the vacuum. And molecular distillation is basically based on the principle of simple distillation with some modification. This is also called as evaporation distillation or short path distillation. The principle of molecular distillation is based on the substances to be distilled have very low vapor pressure. Examples are viscous liquids, oils, greases, waxy materials, and high molecular weight substances. This boils at very high temperature. In order to decrease the boiling point of the liquids, high vacuum must be applied. Then the pressure exerted by vapors above the liquids is much lower. At very low pressure, the distance between the evaporating surface and the condenser is approximately equal to the mean of free path of the vapor molecules. Then molecules leaving the surface of the liquids are more likely hit the condenser surface nearby. Each molecule is condensed individually and the distillate is subsequently collected. As far as the application of these molecular distillation is concerned, it is used for the purification and separation of chemicals of low vapor pressure. So the very first application for the molecular distillation is purification of the chemicals such as trichlorosilyl phosphate, dibutyl phthalate, and dimethyl phthalate. Second application is more frequently used in the refining of fixed oil. Third application is vitamin A is separated from fish liver oil, wherein vitamins is concentrated by this method from fish liver oil and other vegetable oils. The fourth objective, sorry, application is free fatty acids are distilled at 100 degrees Celsius. Fifth applications is steroids can be obtained between the 100 degrees Celsius and 200 degrees Celsius too. sixth application is triglycerides can be obtained from 200 degrees Celsius onwards. Protein and gums will remain as non-volatile residues. Thus, the above mixtures can be separated by molecular distillations. Okay, next we'll see the theory for the molecular distillation. So the mean free path of the molecule is defined as the average distance through which a molecule can move without coming into collision with another. So the mean path, that is lambda, can be expressed mathematically as lambda is equal to neta under root of 3 divided by p rho, wherein p is your vapor pressure measured in case of kilopascal, rho, that is your density, which is measured in terms of kg per meter cube, then neta is your viscosity measured in pascal or centipoise, you can say, when we are talking about especially for the pressure. Lambda, that is mean path length, which is measured in terms of meter. For example, the mean path, that is heavy molecule of butyl phthalate, is about 30 mm and of oil is 20 mm when measured at pressure of 0.1 pascal. So the mean free path can be increased by decreasing the viscosity, which can be obtained at high temperature and low pressure. Thus, the non-volatile substances may become volatile and distillation is possible. The general requirement for the design of the equipment. The evaporating surface must be close to the condensing surface. This ensures the molecule to come in contact with the condenser as soon as they leave the evaporating surface. For this reason, this process is also known as short path distillation. Next point is it should be minimized because the molecular collision should be minimized because they change the direction of the path of molecule. In other words, intermolecular distance should be fairly high. It can be achieved under very high vacuum, usually of order of 0.1 to 1 pascal. The liquid surface area must be as large as possible so that the vapor is evolved from the surface only, but not by boiling. So thus this process is called as evaporation distillation. This is the diagram for the molecular distillations, where you could able to see the different types of labeling conditions are there, that is condenser, heater, feed from bottom itself, and residue or the product from bottom itself, bucket, then vacuum pump connection at right hand side of top of the position. So the centrifugal molecular distillation, still the principle for that is, in this method the liquid feed is introduced into a vessel which is rotated at very high speed, that is your centrifugal action by means of, on account of heating, vaporization occurs from a film of liquid on the sides of vessel. The vapor molecule travels a short distance and get condensed on a adjacent condenser. So each molecule is condensed individually. The distillate is subsequently collected. As far as the construction of these molecular distillation assembly is concerned, basically it consists of bucket shaped vessel which having a diameter of about 1 to 1.5 meter. It is rotated at a high speed using a motor. Radiant heaters are provided externally to heat the fluid in the bucket. So condensers are arranged very close to the evaporating surface. Vacuum pump is connected to the entire vessel at the top. So provision are made for introducing the feed into the center of the bucket for receiving the product and residue for recirculation. The working mechanism for the molecular distillation is, vacuum is applied at the center of the vessel, wherein the bucket shaped vessel is allowed to rotate at high speed. The feed is introduced from the center of the vessel. Due to centrifugal action of the rotating bucket, liquid moves outward over the surface of vessel and forms a film, since the radiant heaters, that is heat the surface. So the liquid evaporates directly from the film, and the vapor, that is molecules, travels its mean free path and strikes the condenser. The condensate is collected into the another vessel, and the residue is collected from the bottom of the vessel and is recirculated through the feed port for further distillation. We'll see next, that is molecular distillation, but with respect to white film molecular distillation still. So if you could able to see this diagram, then you will come to know very easily the simple construction of this molecular distillation. That is rotor, feed, wiper is there, jacket is there, then condenser at left hand side, residues, product and vacuum pump connection. So we'll see the construction. Basically this vessel, which has a diameter of about 1 meter, the wall of the vessels are provided with suitable means of heating jacket. Wipes are provided adjacent to the vessel wall. Wipers are connected to a rotating head through a rotor. The condensers are arranged very close to the wall, that is evaporating surface, and the vacuum pump is connected to a large diameter pipe at the center of the vessel. Whereas the provisions are made for the collecting the distillate and the undistilled liquid residue at the bottom. As far as the working mechanism of molecular distillation with respect to the wipe is concerned, wipe film molecular distillation still. So the vessel is heated by suitable means. Vacuum is applied at the center of the vessel and wipers are allowed to rotate. The feed is entered through the inlet of the vessel. As the liquid flows down the walls, it is sprayed to form a film by PTFE, that is polytetrafluoroethylene wipers, which are moving at a rate of 3 meter per second. The velocity of the film is 1.5 meter per second. Since the surface is already heated, the liquid film evaporates directly, and the vapor, that is molecules, travels its mean free path and strikes the condenser. The condensate is collected into a vessel. The residue, that is undistilled or mean free path not traveled, which is collected from the bottom of the vessel and recirculated through the feed port for further distillation. So the capacity is about 1000 liter per hour. Okay, so we'll see the easier construction of your molecular distillation, where you could able to understand the construction, working and mechanism for the molecular distillation by moving towards this diagram. Okay, so crude oil intake is there, pump, oil reservoir, then high temperature boiling, long triglyceride chains are broken up here at the bottom. Then on top of the diagram, the fractionating column is there, where the fractionization is takes place. The vapors are gonna release into the column. So the molecules are separated depending on their density, and the lightest filtering out by the top and the heaviest from the bottom. Okay, as far as the application for the molecular distillation is concerned, it is applicable by means of in case of your medicinal chemistry, then cosmetic industry, production of vitamins A and D, small sample of the drugs. So we'll going to discuss it one by one. As far as the first application, that is medicine industry is concerned, so acid chloride, amino acid ester, glucose ramification, solanesol, terpene, natural and synthetic vitamins. In case of cosmetic industries, it is used for the production of lanolin alcohol, alkyl glucoside, rose oil, ginger oil, pepper red pigment, production of vitamin A and D. Small sample of drugs, dyes, sterols and hormones are purified by this process. Various natural oils such as castor oils, soya bean, cotton seed oils can be purified by this process. Molecular distillation of these oils removes bulk of low molecular weight impurities, unsaponifiable matter, coloring and odors. Free fatty acids are distilled at 100 degree Celsius. So Our next distillation assembly is your simple steam distillation. Steam distillation is the most common example of differential distillation. It is a technique used for the purification and separation of substances of high boiling points from non-volatile impurities by using steam. Since the component of the liquids of high boiling points decompose at higher temperature, they are not purified by simple distillation. Therefore, steam distillation is preferred. This technique is also used for separating immiscible liquids and is used as an alternative to distillation under the reduced pressure for substances insoluble in water and not decomposed by heat. So, if you could understand this diagram, then we'll come to know very easily the mechanism, construction, working, and the applications of this steam distillation. So the construction is very simple as far as the steam distillation is concerned. So if you could able to see this diagram, then if you the steam is gonna pass from first initial vessel and is get collected there in case of your vapor of your organic liquid which is there in your second flask, that is wherein the steam and the vapors are gonna collected, that is in case of impure organic liquid. And in the third tube you will going to see the steam and the vapor of the organic liquids are gonna received. Then there is a condenser is there, which is for one is for the to sink and one is for the water. And lastly there is a receiver wherein the pure organic liquid and the waters is gonna separated. So the steam distillation, so this is another diagram for the steam distillation where you could understand very easily the construction and working mechanism. So the steam distillation is a method of distillation carried out with aid of the steam. It is used to separate high boiling substances from the non-volatile impurities which separate the immiscible liquids. The principle, that is a mixture of immiscible liquids begins to boil when some of their vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. In case of mixture of water and turpentine mixture boils below the boiling point of pure water, through the turpentine boils at much higher temperature than that of water. As far as the application of the steam distillation is concerned, it is useful for the separation of immiscible liquids. We can cite here the example water and toluene. Extraction at much lower temperature at protect from the decomposition without loss of aroma. So yeah, obviously you can see here that it is useful for the separation of your volatile oils and the certain aroma without losing its efficiency. Then second is it is also useful for the extraction of volatile oils like low anise oil and eucalyptus oil. Third application would be purification of essential oils like almond oil. Camphor is distilled by this method. And last is your aromatic water are prepared. Limitation, which is not suitable when two immiscible liquids react with each other. The construction of assembly, where in case of the steam distillation, the metallic steam can fitted with the cork having two holes. If you could able to see this diagram, okay. The safety tube inserted up to the bottom through one hole to maintain the pressure inside steam. Moreover, when the steam comes out from the safety tube, it indicates that can be empty. Through other hole band, tube is passed and other end of this tube is connected to flask containing non-aqueous liquid in which the tube is dipped. The flask and the condenser is connected with the delivery tube. The condenser is connected to receiver with the help of adapter, and the provision are made to heat both steam can and flask separately. As far as the working mechanism is concerned, the metallic steam can fitted with the cork having two holes, safety tube inserted up to the bottom through one hole to maintain pressure inside the steam can moreover. Okay, so the firstly material from which the volatile oil has to be extracted is placed in the steel above the perforated plate. Steam is applied to the jacketed steel for boiling the water and material in it. At the same time, the steam is also introduced below the materials through a steam pipe from the jacket. Steam carries the volatile oil into the condenser, where the oil condenses and cools in the presence of cold water. Florentine receiver is used for the collecting the condensate. The volatile oils lighter than the water separate from the distillate as an upper layer and are removed from the upper spout. Water runs off from the spout of the left and returns to the steel. On the contrary, in case of the volatile oil, the heavier than the water, the separation is reversed and oil is collected from the lower spout. So this is all about the working mechanism of the steam distillation. Okay, then as far as the uses is concerned, it is suitable for the separating immiscible liquids such as mixture of toluene and water. Then second application is it is useful for the volatile oil from the clove and is an eucalyptus plant can be extracted using this process. Okay, we had seen in detail, but there is one limitation for this steam distillation assembly is it cannot be going to be employed in condition where the immiscible liquid is reacted with water. We'll see next, that is destructive distillation, that is dry distillation, wherein distillate is decomposition product of the constituents of the organic matter burnt in absence of the air. So which is not used in the lab practices but very useful in the industrial process to obtain the valuable product from the wood, coal and animal matter. It involves the heating of dry organic matter in suitable vessel in absence of air until all volatile substances are driven off. The distillate is the decomposition product of the constituents, and the wood distillation industry and the coal carbonation industry provide many useful fuel material with this method. Next is your compression distillation, which is not even in your syllabus, but as far as your GPAT preparation is concerned, I have summed up this destructive distillation, which is also called as dry distillation, and your compression distillation. Wherein compression distillation method was developed to meet the need of Navy and Army for the fresh water from sea water. So the product obtained is quite pure and pyrogen free. Therefore, it meets the requirement of pharmaceutical industry. It is economical from the standpoint of consumption of fuel and water. As far as the feed water is heated in an evaporator for the boiling, which is concerns more about the vapor which gonna produced in tubes is separated from the entrained distilled, and in separator the vapor is then conveyed to compressor, which compresses it and raises its temperature to about 118 degrees Celsius. It then flows to the steam chest, where it is condensed on the outer surface of the tube, and during the condensation heat is released, which is allowed for the heating of fresh feed in the tube. The vapor condensed and the drain off at as distillate. So as far as the fractional distillation next assembly is concerned, which is fractional distillation, it is there in your syllabus. So very simple mechanism, construction, working and applications are there in case of fractional distillation. If you could able to see this diagram, then you'll come to know very easily the construction and working of this fractional distillation. So fractionating column is there, which is exactly fixed towards the chamber or the round bottom flask, which is exactly there in case of your miscible liquids is there. Then thermometer is placed over the fractionating column. Then in the slanting position, the condenser is there, the receiving adapter is there, and the receiver. Okay, so we'll see what exactly it is. So this method is also known as rectification, because a part of the vapor is condensed and returned as a liquid. So that's why it is called as rectification. This method is used to separate out the miscible volatile liquids whose boiling points are closed by means of fractionating column. So fractional distillation is a process in which the vaporization of liquid mixture, which gives rise to a mixture of constituents from which the desired one is separated in pure form. So we'll see the differentiating point of the simple distillation as well as the fractional distillation. In case of simple distillation, this is your wherein the vapor is directly passed through the condenser, where in case of fractional distillation the vapor must pass through a fractionating column instead of directly from the condenser, in which the partial condensation of the vapor is allowed to occur. In case of simple distillation, the condensate is collected directly into the receiver, whereas in case of fractional distillation, the condensation takes place in the fractionating column so that a part of the condensing vapor returns to the still. So the principle of the fractional distillation is, when a liquid mixture is distilled, the partial condensation of the vapor is allowed to occur in a fractionating column. In the column, ascending vapor from the still is allowed to come in contact with the condensing vapor returning to the still. So this result is enrichment of the vapor with the more volatile components, and by condensing the vapor and reheating the liquid repeatedly, equilibrium between the liquid and vapor is set up at each stage, which ultimately results in the separation of more volatile components. The application of the fractional distillation assembly is the fractional distillation is used for the separation of volatile miscible liquids with near boiling points such as acetone and water, chloroform and benzene. The disadvantages are, fractional distillations cannot be used to separate the miscible liquids which form pure azeotropic mixtures. The fractionating column in case of the assembly, wherein the special type of steel heads are required so that the condensation and re-vaporizations are affected continuously. These are known as fractionating columns. A fractionating column is essentially a long vertical tube in which the vapor passes upward and partially condensed, and the condensate flows down the column and is returned eventually to the flask. So the column are constructed so as to offer the following advantages simultaneously. So the first advantage is, it offers a large cooling surface for the vapor to condense, and second advantage would be, and obstructions to the ascending vapor allows easy condensation. So basically this fractionating column are of two type, one is of pack column and another is of plate column. Plate column again divided into the three types, that is CU plate column first, second is bubble cap column, and third one is wall plate column. I am just going to repeat here that plate column which having the another three types, first one is CU plate column, second is bubble cap column, and third one is wall plate column. So we'll see one by one. So these are the examples and the images, if you could able to see on slides, that pack column which having the three types. So one do have the pear shape, rod and disc shape, and another is your rod and disc shape with respect to the curvature note at the bottom. Okay, so we'll see one by one. So pack column, some form of the packing is used in the column to affect the necessary liquid or vapor contact. The packing may consist of single turn helix, that is spirals of wire or glass, glass rings, cylindrical glass beads, stainless steel rings, etc. So the construction of the pack columns are, which basically consist of tower containing a packing that becomes wetted with a film of liquid which is brought into contact with the vapor in the intervening spaces. A long fractionating column is necessary when the boiling points of the constituents are lying fairly close together. A short fractionating column is necessary when the boiling point of the constituents differ considerably. Okay, the applications for the pack columns are, packing must be uniform so as to obtain the proper channel. If packing is irregular, then mass transfer become less effective. Next is plate columns, which I have already told you that plate columns do have the three basic parts, that is C plate type, bubble cap column, and wall plate column. So turbo grid plate is there on the left hand side of your site. So if you could able to see the diagram, then you'll come to know very easily that A and B so are the plat column which is concerns with the turbo grid plate. So general arrangement of the plates in the columns are gonna see that in case of your left side of the PowerPoint. And as far as your second is there, second that is B diagram, that is your zoom diagram which is concerns with the liquid and the vapor circulations on the plates we can which we enable to see. Okay, on the right hand side of yours, the liquid from the plate above is gonna there, then vapor risers, cap and the veer, liquid downcomer is there. So liquid from plate above, liquid downcomer is there, vapor riser, cap and veer is there. So this is basically the bubble cap plate examples. Okay, then next one is your bubble cap, where you could able to see this diagram, then you will come to know very easily by viewing towards the construction and working of this fractional distillation. So we'll see here the plate column. Many forms of the plates are used in the distillation using different columns. It can be divided into the basically three types. I have mentioned two here, so which are commonly used in the pharmacy. So that is bubble cap plate, turbo grid plates is there. But out of these two, bubble cap and their turbo grid, there is sieve plate and the wall plate is also there. So, but as far as our the types of the plate column is there, which is more concerns about the pharmacies, we have mentioned that only, that is bubble cap plates and the turbo grid plates. So bubble cap column is used in large distillation plants and is described below as construction and working. So the construction for the bubble cap is, the column consists of number of plates mounted one above the other. The caps are present on each plates which allow the vapor to escape by bubbling through the liquid. Whereas in case of the working, the ascending vapor from the steel passes through the bubble cap on plate A and the rising vapors will be reaches in the more volatile components. So this vapor when passes through the liquid on plate B and partially condense, then the heat of the condensation partially vaporizes the liquid. And the process of condensation and vaporizations will be repeated at plate C and so on all the way up the column. And each bubble cap plate has the same effect as a separate steel. Okay. Next is your bubble cap. So advantage for this bubble cap are the plate is effective over a wide range of vapor liquid proportion. There is excellent contact as the vapor bubbles through the liquid is. The limitations for this fractional distillation, more about the plate column, that is bubble cap is concerned. So the limitations for the bubble cap is, a layer of liquid on each plate results in considerable hold up of liquid over the entire column. Okay, so that is quite of destructive one. And second disadvantage would be the need to force the vapor out of the caps through the liquid lead to a large pressure drop through the column. And third disadvantage would be the column does not drain when it is not in use. The fourth limitations would be the structure is complicated, making constructions and maintenance expensive. Okay, so the theory for this fractional distillation is suitable for a system when the boiling point of the mixture is always intermediate between the those of pure components. So there is a neither a maximum nor a minimum in the composition curves. So these systems are known as zeotropic mixtures. So examples are benzene and toluene, then carbon tetrachloride and cyclohexane. Okay, so we'll discuss it in detail, that distillation process with respect to the liquid vapor composition diagram. So by looking towards this diagram, when a mixture AB of specific composition is heated, the total vapor pressure that is composed of contributions of PA and PB will rise until it is equal to the external vapor pressure. So the mixtures will be begin to boil here. Okay, and second point would be, the vapor which first forms is enriched in the more volatile component, this behavior is shown at right, exactly I have shown in the diagram. So assume a two component mixtures with a composition of 30% A and 70% B, that is point W, it is there. The boiling point of the mixture is found by drawing a vertical line from W to where it intersects the lower curve, that is point X. A horizontal line drawn from X to where it intersects the vertical axis, that is the temperature, which gives the BP of composition, that is W. Okay, from the point Y, where this horizontal line intersects the upper curve, that is vapor drop, a vertical line to intersect the lower axis and the composition. So the point Z, which gives the composition of the vapor, which is in equilibrium with a liquid of composition W at its boiling point. So by looking towards this theoretical part, by looking towards this diagram, then we'll come to know very easily the mechanism of liquid vapor composition diagram. Okay, so fractional distillation, AB at composition of 5% A boils at temperature L1, and the vapors with the composition V1 enters the column at that temperature. So the vapor will condense to a liquid with composition V1. The condensate L2 has a lower boiling point because it has more of the lower boiling point A, and will thus vaporize at a lower temperature, that is warmed up by coming in contact with the additional vapors from the below, to give the vapors of composition V2. So when we're going to compare these two diagrams together, then we'll come to know very easily what actually this theoretical part is. So these vapors will condense somewhat further up the column to give a condensate L3. If the column is long enough or contains sufficient surface area, that many successive vaporization or the condensation steps, that is theoretical plate, which can occur, the distillate that comes over the tap top is nearly pure A. So distillation yielding pure A, which continues until all of A is removed, after which the temperature at the thermometer rises to the boiling point of B. Then we'll come to know very easily what actually the construction working and the mechanism of these fractional distillations are. Okay, next is your azeotropic and extractive distillation. Azeotropic distillation, in which the azeotropic mixture is broken by the addition of third substance, which forms a new azeotropic with one of the components. And the extractive distillations, that is the third substance added to the azeotropic mixture, is relatively a non-volatile liquids compared to the components to be separated. Okay, so this is your some definitions or the terminology concerns with your azeotropic and extractive distillation. Next one is your azeotropic mixture, that is constant for the boiling mixture. So the mixtures of the special compositions which giving minimum or maximum boiling points than individual components with minimum or maximum boiling point respectively. Okay, so this is all about our distillation part as far as the summary for these distillation total chapter is concerned. So distillation basically a separation of components of liquid mixtures by a process involving vaporization and subsequent condensations at another place. Okay, so the feed consists of a mixture of liquids and the products are separated as pure liquids. So the distillation involves two steps, that is vaporization of liquids, which requires the supply of heat, and the condensation of the individual vapor molecules to become pure liquid, which requires the removal of heat. Hence, two different heat exchangers are applied. Okay, the principles of vaporization of liquids can be understood from the theories of solution, namely ideal solutions and the real solution. Okay, then the last conclusion related with this topic is, further the condensers is placed very close to these. So in this case, the basic
distillation assembly wherein the vapor phase molecules collide, these turns into the liquid and reach the distillation still rather than the getting condensed. So since the liquid have high boiling points, that is low vapor pressure, once again large amount of heat is supplied for the vaporization. So the separation is achieved by lowering the boiling point by applying the vacuum. Further, the condenser is placed very close to the liquid surface such that as soon as the liquid is vaporized, the short free path is traveled and get condensed. Thus, molecular distillation permits the separation of liquids, namely free fatty acids, vitamin A, and fixed oil. So this is all about our total, what you can say, the chapter. Okay, thank you very much. Next, whatever the chapter is there, the next chapter is our drying. Okay, so we will see that drying chapters in our upcoming presentation. So thank you very much.